All right, this one's gonna be on WebP. It is Google's replacement for what was that? JPEG, PNGs, and even animated GIF files. So any of those. Reason why you probably want to use it is because it reduces size, and it still looks good. You know, like the original. So I'm gonna show you some examples here, right? So we have some JPEGs here, right? This one, you know, picture of someone cutting some stuff. This one's tomatoes, right? And this one's the beach here with some houses. And we also have some GIF files, right? So you can do, you know, JPEGs or PNGs. So for still images, you can use this one called cwebp. And you do, if you want to reduce the quality, you do like 50% here. And we'll do the input, which is this gray. And we'll do output, oh, we'll do gray also. Another one, gray, orange, and then we'll call this one webp, right? And notice the file size here, right? This one was the original, which is like 2.11 megs, and this one is just 323k. Now we open this. Can we open this? There you go. You know, it looks almost the same. I mean, unless you have like some sharp eyes, you can see some differences. But if you're just using this like you know, normal person, you probably won't see any difference, and you can save a lot of size here. So this one is probably good for, you know, people who are converting like their family images and stuff like that, where you have too many, and you know, most of those are like a raw images from a either your phone or a digital camera. It can be over megs, right? Each one of them. And this one will reduce it, and you still have, you know, almost the same quality. And not a lot of differences, but the size will be way smaller. I'll probably say WebP, especially for still images, is kind of like the MP3s. You know, MP3s, they have like, we have WAV files, these are really huge files. And then you have FLAC, and then you have MP3s. So I'll say Web, you know, WebP is like the MP3s for images. Really useful. So you can do that with, you know, any of the other ones. So like I said, this is the original, and this is the one that we converted, right? Looks pretty much the same thing, really. What else can we have? If you want to convert, what is that, GIF files, like these ones, there's actually a different command. So normally we use cwebp, right? But if we wanted to do GIF files, we do GIF to WebP, and we do 50% also, and we want to do this Naruto. Why is it not doing that? There you go. And we do output. Now the thing I don't like about this one is like, because it's animated images, it doesn't have like a new extension. It just uses the same WebP, so I don't really know if it's you know, an animated GIF or a still image. So that's the only thing I don't like about what they did here. You know, they use the same file extension, but you can still, you know, convert it here. And you'll see this one doesn't actually save a lot of space. It will save some, but not a lot, right? We'll see it here. So the original one was 3 megs, and this one, you can see 3.18. the original one was 3.25. I mean, you save some space, but not enough, you know. So if you want to use that, you can use it. But what is your ad? It's like if you're using it with still images, that's where you can get the most, you know, file size reduction. So that's pretty much it for, you know, the program, really. You do need to install it, which is called you search in your package manager, it's called lib webp, and hopefully you find it. There you go. So here you go, see, this is lib webp here, right? Anyways, that's how you install that. As far as viewing it, if you can't view it with your image viewer or whatever it is, you can open it with your web browser and load it there, because almost all the new web browsers will support webp, but not every image viewer will support it because it is kind of new. But anyways, that's pretty much it. Now this one is integrated with Image Magic, so unless if you don't want to use you know, this cwebp, you can actually just use what was the syntax for that one? Image Magic, convert, what was the list? Let me give you an example here. Convert delegate here. So Image Magic does use this as a you know, as a backend if you want to use a webp. So you can see here webp, where is that at? What are we doing? So webp, right? So you see it does use you know, the webp if you want to convert it to you know, PNGs to webp or whatever it is. Then I, you know, you can use Image Magic as a front end to that, because most people, they use Image Magic anyways, and you don't really want to change the syntax. So when you're using this with Image Magic, you just do convert, you know, quality 50 and then input output, real simple. So let's say for example we did what was that one? The other one here, tar. And we'll do it again. Actually, we'll do, yeah, just tar. And we'll do webp here. And so if you don't want to like remember another, you know, command with cwebp like this, just use the convert command in Image Magic, and it'll pretty much do the same thing. So you see this one here that we just converted. This is the original one with the beach and all that. And this is the webp one here. Look at this. All right. Pretty much the same thing. So that's how that works. Now, if you want to do this like a, what was that one? If you want to do this like in a for loop, like if you want this whole folder, you can do for I in... Since we have GIF in here and that uses a different command, we don't want to do all that. We'll do all the JPEGs only. So you can do convert. What do we convert? We'll convert all the what is that, dollar I. Alright, and then we'll do output. What is that command for that? Let's see. Percent dollar star. Okay, so we do what was that one? Percent dollar star. Okay, percent star, and then we're gonna close it with the brackets, and then we can do a webp on here. So there you go. So you can do something like that, and it'll convert all the JPEGs, you know, into WebP. We'll wait for it to finish here. But you can see it'll look out, you know, all the JPEG extension, and it'll convert it all to WebP. So if you want to do the whole folder, you can do it that way. That one was because we had, you know, GIF in here, and I didn't want to use that for the GIF files. But if you had like just PNGs and JPEGs only, you can just do star only like that, and it'll do the whole, you know, folder. As far as GIF files, we can do the same thing. We can do GIF. This one we can do for I, and we'll do star dot. What is that? GIF. What was that one? Do. We'll do the same thing. We'll do an I. If I can see over this stupid mic. Let's see here. Oh yeah, we have to do an output too, right? Output, and we'll do what is that, dollar. I hate doing this in the terminal here. Let's see, dot star, and that's it really. You do webp, right? And then we'll do done, and this will convert all the GIF files into webp also. Although, like I said, the GIF files, you don't save a lot of space, you save a little bit. But with still images, you save a bunch, right? But anyways, you save some space, and that's what I like. I normally use this with comic books. I made a few scripts for it. I'll probably talk about it in the next video. But anyways, that's how you use WebP. Normally, you know, if you're like a web developer or like a website maintainer, you probably already use WebP. But I don't see a lot of people using it like, you know, normally in offline in their computer. But I use it mainly just to save space on some of my comic books, because some of those ones are, you know, they have like raw images, or the file size is just ridiculous for something that I'm just going to read like maybe once or twice. And you save a tons of space, you know. Like I said, this one is the MP3 of images, right? And WebP by Google. It is open source, so it's all good. Anyways, that is for this one, all right? What time is it? 1 a.m.? Been a long day. That'll be it for this one.